In this video, we are going to look into how to do the twisting and also interlock earring model. Are you ready? Let's get started. Before we start model, let's take a look on the structure. I'm going to delete some of them so for you to see the form better. We have the pipe structure inside and we also have a twigs structure outside. With this structure, you can also see it is a little bit deformed in a way. So when you have two of them together, it's showing it more like interlocking together. So as long as we can figure out that one part, we should be able to do the rest. We are going to starting from the scratch. Let's draw an ellipse from the top view. It can be any size that you want. I pretty much want to have a size around like this size. And this is a degree 2 curve. We are going to rebuild into the degree 3 so we can have like two direction. We can stay with the same count for the point, but degree we want to change to 3. Once we have changed that, I'm going to pick up this point and this point. Let's do a test. We want this point going up like this. And if we rotate this guy 90 degrees and making a copy, let me turn this into the red color. It's easier for you to see. You can see they kind of going up and down and not touching each other there. So that does make it easier to see. Let's just simply just pipe them. So you're going to get some sort of a structure like this. And you can adjust it later on if you want to, but this is pretty much what we wanted to have, is kind of locking each other. Once we have that, we are going to do our design on the side. Let's figure out how long is this guy by using the command length. It shows 33.396 millimeter. I'm just gonna make a copy. And let's draw a straight line here with exactly the same length, holding the shift. Then that will represent this curve when it is straightened flat. We want to do our design over here. I'm going to use the corny corners and make sure snapping with the center. Snapping over here and coming into the right view to decide how big you want this guy. I do not want it to be like dramatically giant, so somewhere around here will be fine. Once I have that, I'm gonna use the sweep one and choose the rail cross section, and I will get this over here. We're gonna use the twist command under the transform, then you got the twist over here. We're gonna select this one, starting from the endpoint over here to the endpoint on the other side. Make sure the infinity is equal yes. And we want to go from here, 1, 2, 3. Depends on how many times you would like to twist. Then we'll get this shape over here. The second shape that I wanted to do is similar size. So let's draw a circle and roughly about this size. So let me move this on the side. It's not bothering us. So we are going to use the surface sweep one rail. Pick the rail and pick your cross section. Then you will get this pipe looking things. Let's go ahead to cap both of them to be the solid. And we want to moving one back next to each other. Okay. So let's do a test to see how it goes. We're gonna come in here to use the command float along curve. We're gonna float both of the object. The base curve is here. And remember to record the history, and we wanna click on the target curve. All right. If you feel like this is too much, increasing the size too much, since we record the history, we can moving this base curve more close to the center. And they will come in a little bit more. If you want more, make sure you're moving in a little bit. One thing you want to be pay attention is you do not want this to be deformed too much. So I like it to keep it somewhere in the center over there because I'm going to set the stone in the middle. Double check if you like the result. If you do, let's go ahead to rotate in 90 degrees, holding the shift and hit on the Alt key. So you will get the duplication over there. So this will be our twisting interlock earring structure. I have other video talk about the stone setting. Also have a course to show you all different kind of stone setting in the 3D model, how to build them correctly. If you're interested, on the right top corner over here, you will see the link and in the description below. There are a lot more video for the member only at the membership program. Don't forget to sign up with a small monthly fee. Not only you're helping my channel, you're also helping others to learn Rhino. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time.